We want to welcome you to prayer set today. We are going to be going over Acts 6, 8 through 7:35. We will be reviewing the redemption history of the Israelites. And so the redemption story is important to remember, and important for us to remember our redemption history as well. So we just welcome you, Holy Spirit. We just invite you to come in. We invite your glory to be felt and touch hearts today. We love it when you are dwelling with us and that we are dwelling with you. So we just say, come, Holy Spirit, and dwell with us during this prayer set. Okay, now we're going to start with 6:8, and it says, now Stephen, a man full of God's grace and power, performed great wonders and signs among the people. Opposition arose, however, from members of the synagogue of freedmen. They seized Stephen and brought him before the Sanhedrin. All who were sitting in the Sanhedrin looked intently at Stephen, and they saw that his face was like the face of an angel. Then the high priest asked Stephen, are these charges true? And to this he replied, brothers and fathers, listen to me. And that is the wisdom from God as to how to answer that charge and those questions. So we will be praying and worshiping through that. Okay, the God of glory appeared to our father Abraham while he was still in Mesopotamia, before he lived in Haran. Leave your country and your people, God said, and go to the land I will show you. So he left the land of the Chaldeans and settled in Haran. After the death of his father, God sent him to this land where you are now living. He gave him no inheritance here, not even enough ground to set his foot on. But God promised him that he and his descendants after him would possess the land, even though at that time Abraham had no child.
God spoke to him in this way. For 400 years, your descendants will be strangers in a country not their own, and they will be enslaved and mistreated. But I will punish the nation they serve as slaves, God said. And afterward, they will come out of that country and worship me in this place. Then he gave Abraham the covenant of circumcision. And Abraham became the father of Isaac and circumcised him 8 days after his birth. Later, Isaac became the father of Jacob, and Jacob became the father of the 12 patriarchs. Because the patriarchs were jealous of Joseph, they sold him as a slave into Egypt. But God was with him and rescued him from all his troubles. He gave Joseph wisdom and enabled him to gain the goodwill of Pharaoh, king of Egypt. So Pharaoh made him ruler over Egypt and all his palace.
Then a famine struck all of Egypt and Canaan, bringing great suffering, and our ancestors could not find food. When Jacob heard that there was grain in Egypt, he sent our forefathers on their first visit. On their second visit, Joseph told his brothers who he was, and Pharaoh learned about Joseph's family. After this, Joseph sent his father, Jacob, and his whole family, 75 in all, Then Jacob went down to Egypt, where he and our ancestors died. Their bodies were brought back to Shechem and placed in a tomb that Abraham had bought from the sons of Hamor at Shechem for a certain sum of money. As the time drew near for God to fulfill his promise to Abraham, the number of our people in Egypt had greatly increased. Then a new king, to whom Joseph meant nothing, came to power in Egypt. He dealt treacherously with our people and oppressed our ancestors by forcing them to throw out their newborn babies so that they would die.
And at that time, Moses was born, and he was no ordinary child. For 3 months, he was cared for by his family. When he was placed outside, Pharaoh's daughter took him and brought him up as her own son. Moses was educated in all the wisdom of the Egyptians and was powerful in speech and action. When Moses was 40 years old, he decided to visit his own people, the Israelites. He saw one of them being mistreated by an Egyptian, so he went to his defense and avenged him by killing the Egyptian. Moses thought that his own people would realize that God was using him to rescue them, but they did not. The next day, Moses came up on 2 Israelites who were fighting. He tried to reconcile them by saying, "Men, you're my brothers. Why do you want to hurt each other?" But the man who was mistreating the other pushed Moses aside and said, "Who made you ruler and judge over us? Are you thinking of killing me as you killed the Egyptian yesterday?" And when Moses heard this, he fled to Midian, where he settled as a foreigner and had 2 sons.
After 40 years had passed, an angel appeared to Moses in the flames of a burning bush in the desert near Mount Sinai. When he saw this, he was amazed at the sight, and he went over to get a closer look. He heard the Lord say, "I am the God of your fathers, the God of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob." Moses trembled with fear and did not dare to look. Then the Lord said to him, "Take off your sandals, for the place where you are standing is holy ground. I have seen the oppression of my people in Egypt. I have heard their groaning and have come down to set them free. Now I come. I will send you back to Egypt." This is the same Moses that had rejected with the words, "Who made you ruler and judge?" He was sent to be their ruler and deliverer by God himself through the angel who appeared to him in the bush. He led them out of Egypt and performed wonders and signs in Egypt at the Red Sea and 40 years in the wilderness.
Thank you.
Father, we ask you to come and circumcise our hearts for your kingdom. We ask you to cut away anything that our culture has put in our heart that doesn't belong there. We thank you for all you've done. Father, I just declare we have a spiritual famine in our land, and we just need your power and your signs and wonders to come once again. Because it just feels like there's a famine, a spiritual famine, that only you can feed us what we need. Only you can give us what we need.
We thank you for the remembrance of the God of glory that appeared to Father Abraham. He had a living God encounter. And we ask you, God of glory, to just come today and let us encounter your glory. All these things are just amazing and difficult because Abraham could not see that anything was happening like this in the natural. But the amazing thing was the two words, but God promised. Everything turns on that. So we thank you that we can see that in our lives as well. So we just thank you, Lord, for the promises that encompass but God, the power of a living God.
faithful God, you've always been, you will always be. We remember you are faithful God, you've always been. Say it, it is the God. If you say it is the God. If you say it is the If you say it is the what you started, if you promised it, it's as good as done, God.
Faithful to Joseph, and you were faithful to Moses when things looked difficult and hard. And Father God, you are faithful to us. You truly are the ever faithful Father, the ever faithful God. And when you make a promise, you keep it. And so, Father, I thank you that as we walk each day with you, we thank you that we have a Father that is faithful. We have a Father that is a covenant keeper. We thank you that we can trust you when things seem hard, when we don't understand. We thank you that we can trust you. We thank you that you are a good, good Father.
Thank you that we can reminisce with Stephen and look back on these times where Joseph was sold into slavery, but God was with him. And you rescued him from all these troubles, and you gave Joseph wisdom and enabled him to gain the goodwill of the Pharaoh king of Egypt. So that Joseph had favor and made him ruler over Egypt and all his palaces before the famine struck. So we thank you, Lord, that you are with us, you rescue us, you give us wisdom. We are always seen and we are always heard.
Showing up, just keep showing up, God. Would you just keep showing up? Jesus, just keep showing up. Just keep showing up. We need you, Lord. You were present with Abraham, present with Joseph, present with Moses. You show up with Stephen. Would you just keep showing up? Just keep showing up. Just keep showing up. Just keep showing up, God. You were present with Abraham, present with Moses, present with Joseph, present with Stephen. We need you now. We need you now. Just keep showing. Just keep showing up, God. Would you just keep showing up? You were present with Abraham. You were present with Joseph. You were present with Moses. You were present with Stephen. We need you now. We need you here, God. Just keep showing up, God. Would you just keep showing up? We want a taste of you. When you walk in the room, when you walk in the room, want to see your face. We want to see your face. We want to be marked by you. Marked by ask, would you just keep showing up? Would you just keep showing up? Just keep showing up. Just keep showing up. Would you just keep showing up, God? Would you just keep showing up, God? Would you just keep showing up, God? Would you just keep showing up? We need you now. Keep showing up.
Just keep showing up.
Just keep showing up.
You just keep showing up.
You just keep showing up.
You show up at the right time.
Never stop showing your face. Never stop showing your face, God. You never stop showing your face. Never stop showing your face, God. Never stop showing your face. Everything is you, God. You're not a means to an end. You are the end, God. You are the end, God. There's nothing beyond you. You are the end. It's always been you, God. It will always be you, God. Just keep showing up, God. Just keep showing up, God. I need you, Jesus. just keep showing up. I'm nothing without you, God. Just keep showing up. Just keep showing up. You are the prize, God. The greatest gift, God. Just keep showing up.
I feel like there's an invitation for us to repent of places where we have sought the Lord in order to get something or to see something the way like we want to see it, to get over the hump of something, to achieve something. Just like Liam saying, he's not a means to an end. He is the end. He's it. He's the whole thing. And so, Lord, we repent of any times that we've treated you more like a means to an end. Just to be done with suffering or to get to the next thing. You are the thing. You are the one thing. And we just want to know you. And we want to see you. And so we repent for the places in our heart where that gets twisted, and we ask you to cleanse that place in us. We want to be single-minded. We want you to be the one thing.
Father, will you come and be our burning bush? It says as he went closer, he heard the Lord say, I am the God of your fathers, the God of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. And Moses trembled with fear and did not dare to look. Father, will you bring back a reverence to your bride, to your church? Will you bring back a burning bush, Father God, that burns in our hearts, that we want nothing but you, nothing but you. You're the only one that satisfies. You're the only one that satisfies our longing hearts. And we repent of going after anything besides you. So just bring that burning bush to each of our hearts and just show us who we are serving and honoring and worshiping. Give us new eyes. That we bring you such glory with our hearts that are purified by you. Come purify our hearts, Father. Amen.
be loved by you, to love you and be loved by you. This is my success, to love you and be loved by you, to love you and be loved by you. This is my success, to love you and be loved by you, to love you and be loved by you. This is my success, to love you and be loved by you, to love you and be loved by you. My success, to love you and be loved by you, to love you and be loved by you. This is my success, to love you and be loved by you, to love you and be loved by you, Jesus. This is my success, to love you and be loved by you, to love you and be loved by you, yeah. This is my success, to love you and be loved by you, to love you and be loved by you. You are my heritage, Jesus. You're what I'm passing down. You're what I'm passing down to my children, just like my fathers before. You're what I'm passing down. It's you, Jesus. You're my legacy. You're my legacy, Jesus. You're my legacy. You're my heritage. You're what I'm passing down. You're my success. You're my glory, God. It's all you. It's always been you. It's all you, God. You're my legacy. You're my legacy, God. It's always been you. It's always been you. It's always been you, God. It'll always be you, Jesus. You're the success. Loving you. Loving you, that's the grade that I would love you, that I would love you. Not that I would make more money, not that I would be seen as good in the eyes of the earth. That I would love you, God, that I would love you with my whole heart. That's the whole thing, that's the whole point, that's the whole purpose, that's everything, it's just loving you, Jesus, just loving you, God. You would show up, I'd spend time with you, I'd be with you, be with you. That's my greatest success. Nothing else matters, nothing else matters. That I would be with you, God. That I would be with you, Jesus. That I would be with you, God. That I would be with you. That I would be with you. It's the whole thing. It's the whole thing. It's the whole thing, God. The whole thing. There's nothing greater. There's nothing better. There's nothing higher. You're the whole thing. You're the whole thing, Jesus. You're the whole thing. There's nothing more. There's nothing more, God. It's all you. It's all you. It's always been you. There's nothing more, Jesus. There's nothing more. You are success. You are glory. It's all you. Jesus, it's all you. It's always been you, God. It's always been you. Nothing else matters. Nothing else will ever come close. is taken, you can have it all. And give me Jesus. Take it, you can have it. Take it, you can have it all. Just want Jesus. Take it, you can have it. Take it, you can have it all. I just want you, Jesus. I just want you, Jesus.
I sense that the place where we are, the place where we're standing, is holy ground. I thank you that you have seen the things in our lives that are oppression to us. You have heard our cries and our groaning. And you have come today to set us free, afresh and anew. And he does not want us to go back to Egypt. The Lord gave me a picture this morning, and it was of a huge rubber stamp, which is kind of old school, but it's a big old stamp. And the ink pad was red, and the Lord was stamping hearts that are very closed and need areas to a breakthrough. He was stamping relationships that have grown cold and are difficult. He is stamping areas of finance that just need to move. Whatever else is defined by the difficult stuck spots in our lives. And so what the Lord was doing is that little phrase, but God, the pivot point of change of how we see things. He's stamping hearts, he's stamping minds, he's stamping mouths, he is stamping even places of yes that we want to go, but the timing is not right yet. So I just think we need to sit here and let the Lord bring to mind places that he has stamped our hearts, stamped these situations, just as we look back in remembrance of the redemption of Israel. These are places in our lives that the Lord has a story of redemption to write, and he wants to put our redemption story in the story of the Israelites' redemption. So I just thank you, Lord, that you have made a space for some sacred time so that we take our sandals off and know that today we are standing on holy ground. And this holy ground is for moving forward, for seeing that you are with us. You are a living God, and you desire to hear. You are the only thing that we want. And so we have in our hearts done that today. And I just want to make sure that everybody has a little space to continue so that when we walk out, we don't walk out back into our Egypts. We walk out into the freshness of what you have, no matter how long the wait or the change, Lord. You are at work. You are at work. And we thank you for this glimpse of redemption in the past, overlaid in our future.
So I'm just sensing that the Father was saying, because I'm inside of you, everywhere you walk is holy ground. And so, Father, that is truth, that you're inside of us. Will you help us be more and more aware that we have your holiness inside of us, that we are one with you because of Jesus Christ, and that our old self is dead. Help us remember that, and it is our new self. It is our new creation, our born-again creation, Father, and that as we walk, let us look with holy eyes upon the world the way you do. May we look through the eyes of holiness when people are hurting and need you. And so, Father, we ask you to help us remember wherever we walk, we're walking with you, and it is holy ground.
Stand as holy ground. Wherever you go is sacred space, God. Wherever you stand as holy ground. Wherever you go is sacred space. Sacred spaces. I want to rest on holy ground. I want to live in sacred spaces.
I want to live in sacred spaces.
I want to dwell in holy ground.
I want to dwell in holy ground.
Holy ground. Wherever you go.
Father, thank you that as we leave here, every place we walk, we want to think about you and what you want to do through us. So we thank you that you're holy. We thank you that you meet us where we're at each day. And we thank you that you always show up, that you always show up. And let us just be so sensitive to your spirit. We thank you that you are a promise keeper. We thank you that you're a covenant keeper. We thank you for the sacrifice of Jesus Christ. And you guys are dismissed.